what's the name of this pimp I'm supposed to be looking out for?
Ted.
Ted? Oh, Ted, that's right, yeah.
Anything else?
Yeah, I put in for an extra 500 quid. Expensive business, this.
Hello. What's your name?
Cheryl. What can I get you?
I'd like a beer, please. Cheryl.
Anything else?
Yeah, you could ask that young lady to pop over when she's got a moment.
Of course, sir.
Would you care to join me?
That's Uncle Ted. Lucas didn't waste much time, did he? He won't find out you're spying on him.
Oh, you said he never comes in here.
No, he just sits out there and tells my father he's keeping an eye on the business. The joke is, he's the one that's going to get us shut down.
And have you told your dad you think Ted is using this place to recruit girls and clients?
I can't. He wouldn't believe me. And anyway, I don't want to cause a family rift.
Yeah, but if we catch him, it allows you to play the innocent, right?
Is that so wrong?
Well, Elizabeth, we've got people on the floor, cameras everywhere. If he puts a foot wrong, we'll get him.
Nifty.
They keep me amused when I'm in here resting with the girls' shifts.
Is this one of, Ted's girls?
Chrissy, yes, I think so.
Looks like you're in there, Frank.
The place is swarming with cops.
Your niece. She's on to you. She called us in. Bitch.
No, you can't blame her, Ted.
The kind of setup she's got here has got to be as clean and smooth as a lap dancer's snatch. Or they shut it down.
You the gaffer on this one, Frank?
No, my number two's running this one. I thought it'd be better if I fed back the information.
She's an evangelist, you know, little Lizzie. Believes her way is the only way. A tasteful world, mind screwing. Sorry, lap dancing.
There are only so many bodies a man can look at before he has to get stuck in.
Exactly.
Mind you, she hasn't got it all wrong, has she? I don't recall antibacterial lemon and eucalyptus scented hand wash in your clubs, Edward.
Which ones are cops?
Just imagine they all are. Lie low and leave the rest to me.
Let me set you up with someone. As a way of saying thank you.
Haven't you been listening? Tell your girls to stick to their day jobs, no extras, until this thing blows over.
You like Chrissy. I could tell.
I'm working.
Can you
Come on.
Yeah, that's right. Yeah, yeah.
Must have the thinnest landing strip.
Yeah, well, none at all.
I'm going for a break, then I'll take over from you.
I don't mind staying, if you like.
No, it's, okay.
What's up with her?
How long have you got?
Hello. You all right?
Great.
What's your name?
Adam.
I'm Andrea. Can I dance for you?
Yeah.
He looks like he's about to have a tooth out.
It's probably his first time.
Hello.
These are on me. Just giving you a taste of. Are you ready for more? Maybe later then.
I don't think so.
That's a real shame.
Cole is following one of the girls, and Parks and Vickers are as happy as pigs in shit, and that's all.
Thank you, Kirsty.
Are you sure you don't want an extra pair of eyes?
Yeah, I'm fine. You get off.
Our new body oil. What do you think?
Elizabeth, go.
You work and I'll give you a little massage. It's only hand cream, really. It just smells nicer.
Yeah, and cost five times as much.
But it'll still walk off the shelves, because my girls use it. Clients will be able to buy it and take home a little piece of the Cornflower Blue experience.
But they can't touch the girls, right?
No, that's not an offer. But they can smell the oil on the girls' skin. Imagine what it would be like to run their hands over it. Going away this year.
I haven't really thought about it.
Don't leave it too late. I've booked mine. Jamaica. That's what I trade on, Joe. Imagination.
And loneliness.
Men come in here to escape from reality. In here, everything is perfect. Exciting. Special.
Just imagine if you could bottle that.
You're in foreign exchange. What's the exchange rate now?
Sorry, I can't remember.
Adam, would you like me to take my bra off?
Yeah.
Put 10 quid in my G-string.
Could we go somewhere else?
For 20 quid, I can dance naked for you in a private booth.
I was thinking of something more than that.
Sex.
Yeah. Oh. Andrea, what?
Of course you leave.
answer. Guys.
Bloody hell, you've only been in there 2 minutes.
Guys, come on, I was just having a laugh, yeah? Oh, come on, I'm sorry, I'm sorry. You let me stay.
I'm sorry, sir, you've broken house rules.
Said maybe see you again.
Can't keep me away. Thank you. Thank
you. I thought you'd gone home.
Oh, went for a drink, got the munchies, thought you might be hungry as well. But, smoked salmon or salt beef?
Oh, no, I'm gonna get off.
Well, I can shut up shop if you like. I've got some things to write up anyway.
Thanks. Enjoy your supper. In a second, yeah?
Adam might as well have had police tattooed on his forehead. He's got to learn to blend into surroundings, Joe.
Kirsty, that's enough. Anyone gives Adam advice, it's me, not you.
Frank, how'd you get on last night? Any leads with the girls?
Well, when Adam got himself chucked out on his ear, it didn't seem quite the right time to go asking for extras, you know what I mean?
What about Ted? Any idea which girls are working for him? Come on, Frank, you were with him for ages. Was he sussing any of them out as potential prostitutes?
It's early days, Joe. I'm just getting to know him.
And?
Well, he knows his cricket and his horses. Toronto Brave in the 2 o'clock at Lingfield, if anyone sees that.
And that's it, yeah?
Well, for now. Sorry.
OK, well, let's get some leads today.
Boss.
Hmm?
Boss, about that word.
You're sure it was Vickers? Okay. Okay, leave it with me. I'll get an explanation. You just carry on as normal.
I don't think I can.
Lorraine, don't blow this out of proportion. Lorraine. He's in there to talk to the girls, yeah? He was probably just talking to her. Okay.
See ya.
Yeah. Leave it with me. Don't say a word. Not a word.
Oh, I'm not as good at late nights as I used to be.
Thanks, Frank.
You know, I was thinking. Ted's been running the family business now for, what, 20 years? Well, almost as long as you've been around. It's amazing you haven't come across him before.
Yeah. Well, I'm new to vice, you know. Tell you what, though, Joe, if he is poncing, he's not very good at it. I've dropped enough hints, and he had loads of opportunities of setting me up with a Tom. Nada. Are you sure this Lizzie's giving you the right facts?
Lizzie?
The manager.
Elizabeth.
His niece, whatever.
So none of the girls got friendly with you all night?
Sadly, no.
What about after everyone went home?
Well, I did pop back in for a slash. One of the girls opened up for me. I suppose you could call that friendly. I was desperate.
The thing is, Frank, why would she risk letting you back in?
I don't know. I'm a nice guy. Oh, I'm sorry, I forgot to mention it. Whew. Senior moment.
No worries. Old timer.
Oh, splitting headache. Have you got any brain pills? Let's see. Oh, I'd be on antidepressants if I were on Fiverr an hour. You're not pretty much in tips either, are you?
I'm happy.
No, you're kidding. Look, you're really attractive. Well, you would be if you made more of yourself. You could easily make more money at the Punters. I could sort you out.
I'm sorted out, love. Been there, got the T-shirt.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, I'd rather be poor and safe. You're playing with fire. You sell your body, you get damaged in some way, sooner or later.
Well, who said anything about selling their bodies?
That's what you do out there.
No, it isn't. But it's what you did, isn't it? You were a Tom. What happened?
Don't want to talk about it.
Okay, fair enough.
Well, that looks serious.
It is. I'm training to be a doctor. I'm going to specialise in dermatology. So neither of us are as dumb as we look.
But our main success is not the figures. Through our marketing, we've successfully sold people the idea that Cornflower Blue is fun, clean, respectable. We are the acceptable face of live adult entertainment. Starting with these sites, I'm going to build the Cornflower Blue brand. I want one on every high street, nestling in between the burger bars and the coffee chains. As long as a building has a public entertainment license and no conditions attached, we can buy it and create a new Cornflower Blue. It's that simple. I'm offering each of you an exciting new brand in which to invest your money. Can you afford not to grasp Cornflower Blue with both hands and make it your own? Thank you.
And you? Lizzie is rather arresting, isn't she? Ted Bascombe, Major Shell.
Inspector Joe Robinson. Vice.
What are you doing here?
License renewal. Looks fine.
That's great, Joe. Great. Please excuse me.
Yeah. Hello, Joe.
Hey. Now, you didn't tell me you were planning to take over the world. I can see why you're so anxious to get shot of Ted.
We were on the same side.
I'm on my side.
Yeah.
For me? Well, these will come in handy later.
I was wondering, would you like to have dinner tonight? There's a private room above the club. We could be discreet.
I don't mix business with pleasure.
Mixing the two is my motto.
Gets people into trouble.
But after the case is over.
When do you think your lot will be out of here?
Losing money?
All the inconvenience. I've got my regular clients, but we do pick up new ones here.
Yeah, but you got your other houses, though, haven't you?
Oh, yeah. got three ticking over nicely. Bloomsbury, Hampstead, Heathrow.
Let me give you a tip. You want to make sure to keep them apart. No documents to link them. My lot are red hot on a paper trail these days.
Andrea saw it out, a beautiful system. Even you would have trouble cracking it.
Andrea? Little Miss Silvernick is out there.
Been together a year now.
Oh, she's into dinosaurs then.
Want to meet her?
Doesn't it bother you? Other men?
No. She only loves one of them.
Right.
Hi, Cheryl.
Hi.
You know, dark colours really don't suit you.
I'm in mourning.
Who for?
For me.
How's business?
Oh, it's down.
You?
Oh, it's all right. She's a bit weird, but she's all right.
My earnings have halved. That bloke that got chucked out, was he one?
Yeah. Shame. He was really cute.
Anyone fancy a drink?
Oh, I can't. I've got exams revised for tomorrow.
I'll test you. I'm not doing anything tonight.
You really know, mates, or what? Oh, we'll come round tomorrow, but not too early.
This better be bloody good. You could blow your cover, maybe, on the street like this.
Well, Adam being thrown out wasn't just an accident. They knew he was a copper.
What about you?
No, I'm in there, especially with this one girl, Andrea. We're getting on really well. She's a student, medical student.
Yeah. Are you sure you haven't been rumbled?
I'm sure.
Well, that's OK, then. The problem left with Adam. You just carry on as if nothing happened.
Yeah. I was intending to.
Good.
How did you get on with Vickers?
I told you, Lorraine, don't worry about it.
Boss, I've been looking at a few of his old files and, at first glance, they seem okay, but you take a closer look and things just don't add up. I mean...
Sit down. Did I ask you to do this?
No, but I thought it would be...
You thought wrong. You didn't think. And you don't know. Frank Vickers is lethal. Don't let him get anywhere near close to you.
I was doing this to help you.
Forget about me. If he finds out you've been picking through his history, your fast-track career will grind to a halt.
Well, I want to do the right thing.
Then listen to me. Stop what you're doing.
If that's what you want.
Lorraine.
I'm really sorry, okay? It's just... you're the best thing that's happened to this unit in years. And I don't want to lose you.
Thank you. Why do they do it, eh? Guys like him.
5 minutes of intimacy. 5 minutes of feeling like the best thing since sliced bread. Women buy wonder bras, men buy lap dances. Personally, I think it's good value.
But what they really want is sex.
Oh. Cornflower Blue isn't about sex. Burger chains don't try and sell you steak, do they?
I wouldn't know. I don't eat in them.
I'm like you. I live for my job. I mean, I know I'm good at it because the till receipts say so, but I still don't really believe it. I feel like a fraud.
Yeah. Everybody feels like that sometimes. I mean, I look at my badge and I wonder if I deserve it.
Joe? What is it?
Oh, it's just tiredness. I'm okay. Thanks for the coffee.
Right. What is the name of the larger nerve plexus in the skin which responds to mechanical stimuli of pressure and tension?
Ow. Pacinian corpuscles.
Correct.
Yes. Come on, I'll do your nails. Have you got someone special?
Nah, nobody gives a shit about me, Andrea.
There must be someone.
Yeah, there was. He's in prison. Isn't Ted a bit old for you?
No, he's warm and funny and I love him.
Yeah, it's all right for now. But isn't it weird, that kind of age gap? I mean, your friends and his friends, do they get on?
I don't really have any friends at uni. Now, whilst they're all out getting bladdered on Dog Bolter, I'm showing my arse to complete strangers.
Just like students do.
Well, I could introduce you to some of Ted's friends, if you want. There's a very cute gynecologist. But you're waiting for your bloke to get out.
He's not my bloke. Did I say he was my bloke?
Oh, I'm sorry I spoke. He's my friend. And it's because of me he's in prison. That is my fault. He killed someone. No shit. But that's not your fault.
It is. He killed the man who raped me.
What, Punter?
Yeah. And I let it happen because I was out of it. But if I just fought back a bit harder and I hadn't been in that bloody shitty flat in the first place, then Pat's life wouldn't have turned to crap and neither would mine.
You didn't want me to pursue this investigation. It really gave me a hard time. Said it was a waste of resources. Now I know why.
You think I'm a coward, don't you?
Oh, of course not. You know what you're dealing with.
You were right what you said yesterday, Lorraine. Truth is, I'm not just worried about your career. I'm terrified about destroying my own. I lost my family because of this job. Now, I might not be much good at being an inspector, but it's all I am.
It's not all you are. You're much more. You're inspiring, special. You're better than him.
But I'm not as clever, Lorraine. I'm not as clever. I mean, what have I got on him, really? A lot of might-haves. Might have tipped off an old mate. Might have shagged a dancer. Might have been a bit slack with a few investigations. That's not enough to finish a man like Vickers.
Is that what you want to do?
If I take this on, it's what I have to do. It's all or nothing.
Put him under surveillance.
What?
I'm serious. He's not going to do anything while we're watching him. If we pack up, go home, tell him the investigation's a dead duck, that he was right all along...
Flattery.
...his guard will be down.
That's it. You are brilliant. Your boss.
Could be our secret.
No. No more secrets.
How do you want to play it?
I'm closing the investigation down. Now.
Yeah, I see. Okay, boss.
It's a non-runner, Frank.
Yeah, you're making the right call, Joe. I always think it's best just to hold your hand up and say, I made a mistake.
Yeah. So do I.
I ought to be going, really.
Oh, I'm sorry, I'm so boring. Look, don't go, Cheryl. I know. Let's give work the flick tonight. Have a girly night in.
I don't know.
Well, now that you've got everything off your chest, you deserve a drink. Well, I need a drink. Come on, let's celebrate.
All right, go on.
I'm outside a restaurant at 13 Davies Street. No, I won't tell you what it's about, Kirsty. Just get here as soon as you can. Yeah, bring him as well.
Rainbow roll. Yeah, cheers, Michelle. Yeah, two bottles. That's great, yeah, cheers.
Oh, you look better.
I feel it. It means a lot to me, you know, you're listening to all of that.
Book, film, theatre, how many words? Is Vickers aware of this?
Not yet, no.
Do you want me to let him know?
No, I don't want you to let him know. I'll let you know. That's how it works around here, OK? Get off my back.
Bloody hell. I thought you stood the investigation down, Joe.
Kirsty, can you stop questioning me for once? I know exactly what I'm doing.
This is the life. What is this?
Eel.
Tastes like men's unwashed testicles. Hello. Hi, Ted. Yeah, I was knackered. No, I've got a friend over. Who? Oh, yeah, yeah. OK, yeah, I'll sort it. Yeah, bye.
Boss, permission to ask a question. Is Vickers still undercover? So we should treat him like a suspect.
I'll do the arrests. You're just here to back me up.
There's only three of us, Joe.
Yeah, and only one arrest I care about.
Wanted to tell you before, I'm not just a student, a dancer. I'm a prostitute. So we're the same, you and I.
Where'd you work from?
Here. Well, Ted brings his friends home. He's on his way home with one now. A real sweetie. Now is your opportunity to put everything behind you and get back to work. But I understand if you don't want to, it's fine. I'll call another girl in. God, he's always forgetting his keys. It's your call.
Celebrating with my
mates. Cheryl, this is Frank.
Well, hello, Cheryl.
Oh, I'm sorry, I shouldn't have suggested anything. No, no,
it's fine, it's fine. Why don't you and Ted have some time together? Leave me and Frank here to have a chat. Get to know each other.
Hello. Happy? Never been happier.
Just give me enough time to get things underway. Not too much time.
You know, you don't make a bad little tart, really. A bit uptight, but then I can't blame you for that.
What the hell are you playing at?
Have you got a handkerchief with your initials embroidered on it?
Why would I?
No, of course you haven't, you kid. You don't know what a proper handkerchief is. Everything you lot use is throwaway. Nothing lasts. My generation, we like permanence. We got traditions, possessions, friends that last a lifetime.
Yeah, I know. You're talking about Ted. Joe doesn't know you two have got a past, does he?
Yeah, of course he does. Why do you think he sent me undercover? Why do you think I'm here?
You tell me. The investigation's over, Frank.
And what about you, Cheryl? What are you doing here?
Andrew's my friend. I'm socialising.
You're not supposed to socialise with suspects, but then that's what you do, isn't it? You get a bit carried away. Does Joe know you're here? Oh, dear. You're pretending to be a Tom again, aren't you? I think I'd better take another look at your psychiatrist's report.
You came here to have sex with a prostitute.
Did I? And there was me thinking I'd come here to arrest Ted. Shall we get on with it?
Who's that? Joe?
I'm sorry, Ted. There's been a bit of a complication.
Is it Cheryl?
I'm afraid so.
What's wrong with her?
She's a cop. And so am I.
I know that, Frank.
You don't have to say anything, but tell me now if you've got an excuse, because later may be too late. I'm arresting you for poncing.
Cheryl!
Police Constable Hutchins to you.
It's all right, darling. Frank, let her off. She's just at the start of her life. Everything in front of her, everything still to play for. Give her a break for me. Please.
And I'm afraid you're nicked for allowing your premises to be used as a brothel.
You set me up.
I didn't have to, Andre.
Evening, Joe. Ah, you lot were quick off the mark. Well done. I'll bring you out to speed back at the Nick, all right?
Yeah.
Did you know she was in there?
No.
Put her in a car, please.
I'm not going anywhere with that bitch. Fine. You can come with this one, then.
Cheryl, I had no idea you... Cheryl!
It's a bugger. Can't help it if your own team were too good, Frank.
It's married.
Gosh, I'd not be the same without you, Ted. And what have I got to look forward to, eh? Sanitised future with identikit girls and dull eroticism. No adventure, no risk. I feel like doing time myself.
I'll make sure you're all right, Frank.
Cheers.
My other little concerns. You don't have to do anything about them, do you? You can sit on that. It's nothing you haven't done before.
I'm sorry.
I said it's nothing you haven't done before.
Do you know, my memory's not what it used to be.
Mine's suddenly as fresh as a daisy. I'm sure your superior would love to hear how you've been dipping your wick in my girls for 20 years.
Kirsty, bring Andrea in the number one.
You can't let them see each other.
Watch the door, Kirsty. Watch the door. Just give me a moment to... Isn't she lovely?
Shit! Get off me!
Let her go. Ted, this is the bit I like.
What do you want?
You cooperate, I get a result, and Uncle Frank will take good care of your beloved till you get out.
The university won't find out about this.
If you turn up and testify in court,
then you stop working as a prostitute.
Piss off,
Andrea.
No. Why should I? Who does she think she is? Tell me what I can and can't do. She's no better than me.
She's a Tom.
It's called undercover police work.
It wasn't. The thing she told me.
PC Hutchins was acting, Andrea.
Yeah, jealous of me, were you? Did I have everything you wanted?
Andrea.
Too happy for you, was I?
No, Andrea.
So you took it all away. Ted, my job at the club, my earnings. I was doing all right until I believed your sob stories about being raped. Oh, you wouldn't believe the job your mate did. And it wasn't just rape. It was drugs too. Porn videos. Oh, her best friend murdered the rapist. Huh. Fucking hell, you should nominate her for an Oscar.
Just make sure you ask about those three knocking shops.
I've got the foot soldiers out already, bringing in the girls and the punters. And by the way, I call Lizzie to tell her the good news. Hope you don't mind. So, in the end, everything works out quite well, didn't it?
Yeah. For everyone.
You know, Joe, I don't envy you this new world of vice. Run by women, for women. Elizabeth's place might be all corporate gloss, but underneath, she's still in the same old swamp as the rest of them. Ted's out of the way for now, but someone else will take his place.
I'm gonna give Cornflower Blue the all clear, Frank.
Of course you are. Just make sure she knows who's in charge.
And who is in charge, Frank?
Well, technically, I am. But as you well know, my days here are numbered. The Home Office is still calling, Joe. And when I'm gone, this little empire will be all yours.
Just to let you know, the other brothels have been raided.
That's quick.
Seems you've got a result, sir. Congratulations.
That's right.
Well done, Joe.
Lorraine. I just want to say thanks for everything, yeah?
Yeah. And what was that you were saying about not getting too close to lethal people?
suppose it's too late for dinner.
Forgot my bag. Cheryl? You could always talk to me, if you wanted.
I'm gonna be okay now. To all those moral qualms. Not that I'm complaining.
It's what I wanted. It's what you wanted.
Well, yes.
Yeah. I mean, it's a mutual agreement, right? I mean, it's exactly what goes on here at your club. And the girls offer their bodies for viewing and the men buy them. Everyone's happy. I've sorted out your problem for you. And you sorted out mine.
When can I see you again?
You've got the office number if you are in more trouble.
I don't understand.
What's the matter, Elizabeth? Don't you believe in the buy and sell principle of your little empire?
That's business. This is pleasure.
You don't separate the two.
I thought we had something in common. I mean, I really want to see you again.
Sorry. That's not an offer.